I'm very proud of my releases that I've had so far. You know, starting out as a, I started out signed to a label, and when I went independent, my first release was Tempted. And it's really interesting, you know, doing your own thing, you know, not having anybody telling you what to do and just kind of trying to put your own vision out there. And for Tempted, you know, it was a combination of everything that I loved. It was R&B, it was a little bit of soul, a little bit of jazz, and a little bit of opera, if you could believe that. So we kind of combined all these things together, and I had two different producers on the project. I had Jerry Jackson, which at the time in Chicago, he was very known. He had produced DeBrat. We all know who DeBrat is. And also You Mind, and a few other groups in the 90s that were really happening at the time. So, you know, I just felt really cool being in Chicago and working on this project and really kind of growing up in the business. I was still so young, but trying to put this vision out there. So Tempted was, like I said, it was a little bit of everything. Like, I was influenced by things happening on the street, you know, living in Chicago, kind of the first place I've ever lived away from Michigan, was really super exciting for me. So, you know, you hear a lot of grindy, you know, just gritty, grindy hip-hop kind of influences, and you know, it was a lot of fun. So if you haven't listened to that, you should check it out, because you can kind of tell where I was as a really young girl, kind of her first time away from a small town, you know, and just kind of throwing that into a project. So Tempted was a lot of fun. We had a lot of success with Tempted. We performed on the Jenny Jones Show. Tempted was played on radio stations all across the country. That was really exciting. And it was my first time going on tour, like, as me, just out there, me and my music. So that album will always have a special place in my heart, because, you know, I was a child, you know, out there doing something big for the first time on my own without my parents or any type of adult supervision, really. So, yeah, that was Tempted. And I left Chicago, moved to New York City, and was there during the horrific events of 9/11. And, you know, there's a lot of anger. And when I wrote Power of a Woman, you know, that record had three different producers, mainly Antar Goodwin, who is an incredible bass player that I had the opportunity to tour with. And, you know, that album was really a growing up period for me, because I was able to kind of start to fuse the R&B and the rock that I love so much. Like, I was kind of like marrying them together in this really unorthodox way. So Power of a Woman was just really incredible. I got to put a lot of anthems that I had written out there, and just a lot of female empowerment and you know, heartbreak, songs about heartbreak, and songs about, you know, just being a powerful woman, and also songs about falling in love with Fly So High. So it was a great, great album, a lot of fun. And moving on from there, I started traveling. You know, I went to India, I went to Israel, I went to Peru, I went to Tibet, you know, and from all those influences, I came home and I wanted to do a kirtan album. So I wrote and chanted Surrender all in one day at home in a closet. I know you're probably thinking in a closet, but yeah, you know, at the time I had a really small apartment because I had just moved to LA, and that's Los Angeles, and my vocal booth was in a closet. So I just went in there, I pressed record, I went in there and just chanted. So, you know, Surrender is very heart-sent and, you know, just very pure. And going on from there, you know, I needed to get back into the vein of rock and roll again. And, you know, just, you know, as you grow as an artist, you're always wanting to try different things, experience different things, and say different things with your music. So the next project was Rockaholic. And Rockaholic was just, you know, I was finally feeling really good and confident with my guitar playing. And all I wanted to do was wail. I just wanted to get that whammy pedal, and I just wanted to wail all over my guitar. That's all I wanted to do. So you hear a lot of that in Rockaholic. A very fun project, and if you love rock, like, you'll love, like, all the guitars all over that project. And then moving back, you know, it's like, I took another trip to India, and this time, when I came back, I just really wanted to share what I felt like I went through. I felt I went through somewhat of a spiritual awakening. And so the next project focused on those chants and things that I was learning. You know, I was learning them in the different yoga traditions. I was learning, you know, Hindu chants, and I was learning Gurmukhi. And, you know, I put that all into awakening mixed with some of the R&B infusion, a little bit of reggae. So I was just kind of in that pure space of wanting to combine everything. And that's kind of what you get with awakening. And upcoming is, I'm super excited about this next project, which I'm not going to release the name right now. You'll have to wait and see. But I'm really excited because this next project is really going to be just so crazy. It's rock. It's opera. It's R&B. It's hip-hop. All in one album and all fused together. So it's like the purest expression of me musically that you will experience. So I hope you will check it out. It's